East Wake baseball chief Tony Pierce and company conjured up a three-game success spell. While Roseville used group therapy to deal with back-to-back defeats. Where Warrior Resistance faced Roseville Aluminum 16-stick Insistence. From Austin Buffalo's first inning single, Onward.
Pitching today, number 17, Bradley Wilburn.
Bradley Wilburn would go 3-0 with a 1.97 ERA on the season. He balanced five hits with five strikeouts. His buddies, 6'4" DP, helped in the first. In the second, Grant Homan hoisted a single with eyes through the skies. He certainly was Houdini here, avoiding the tag to swipe second. Ta-da! Following a walk, Jaden Bailey's sack bunt put two Rams on the brink. Where Caden Gonzalez's plunging pitfall punctured a pair of points. Then hot hitter Michael Gupton and his 600 average was hit instead. Loading the bags for 438 batter Buffalo's sack grounder. Then 381 thumper Spencer Faulkner's right staff. It was already 3-0 prior to East Wake's escape. The Warrior half was a parade of stops by a full step. Or in this case, a few more to spare. Tristan Purser promptly put Ben Lister in pursuit of a deep double. Then Homan bought this ticket aboard via foot fault. Bailey belted a scoring single to center. Then Gonzalez steered a line drive for two runs, bringing up the fastest 55-meter junior sprinter in America. Michael Gupton went long, then went on the double to score in position. Where he next snatched his 15th steal of the Steel Young season, safely securing 15 of 16 attempts, boosting him to the top of the statewide stats in that category. He next tallied on a Davis goading single. Roseville stretched its spread to 8-0. Dawson Creech answered with a comebacker as a comeback attack. But Will Burn burned the challenge by flamethrowing some high heat, earning coach Jake Gross's K kudos.
Come on, you gotta give it to me, you gotta give it to me.
Homan reapplied the ram pressure. Nick Newman's knock preceded Gonzalez's short stroke. Cameron Ralston's free cruise, toting an unrubbed bruise. Jordan Overton's sack sand. Kevin Jones, clobber. All that collected in an 11-0 elevation. Cole Alphen finally rallied the Warriors with an unconventional on-base concoction. Ant Brown took a more traditional approach, like launching a wallop off the wall. Here, Mr. got my attention. Then he made this stripe indention. Aiden Houck's sacrifice grounder could have been more if Gonzalez had not kept his cool. Dylan Wells' single concluded the 11-3 retaliation. Pollard's spicy pepper and Davis Mosley's hustle rustled up a ram-blanking fifth. However, Wilburn whooped a 1-2-3 bottom of his own. Rolston's rip produced the RIP for East Wake's fine chance. Because Jordan Overton overwhelmed the hot corner. Then Kevin Jones bombed a two-bagger far left. Then Drew Gupton ferried a pair to shore by paddle. It was 14-3. Jones shortened the game despite a Lister lick plus a Jacob Falls maul. His wrap-up blow-by gusted his group to 5-3 overall. East Wake bid bye-bye at 3-4. This is Don Fuller, East Wake Television.